Welcome back. This afternoon, we are joined once again by choreographer and director Renaud Wiser, who will be presenting part two of his choreographic workshop. A reminder, whether you're a budding choreographer or as a dancer, you are looking to hone your interpretive skills, this workshop will have something for everybody. Renaud has enjoyed a performance career in both ballet and contemporary dance, and has presented his choreographic work extensively in the UK through the Renaud Wiser Dance Company. Now, health and safety, as always, be aware of the space that you're in and adapt the work where necessary. Make sure you're wearing appropriate clothing that you're able to work in. And if you do have any injuries today, make sure you don't practice, but of course, watch and learn, taking as much information as you can. And then drop back in with us in the future when you're feeling better. This workshop, along with all the classes this week, will be available for you to see once again in the future online. So without any further ado, let's hand over to Renaud. Thank you, Renaud.
Hello and welcome to this choreographic session. I'm Renaud Wiser and thank you, Richard, for having introduced me. Very happy to be here with you today and doing this work together. So today we're going to be exploring movement in various ways. We're going to warm up together first, then do some improvisation, learn a choreograph sequence that I've made up, and then I will give you some instructions to create your own work at home and perform it alongside the sequence that we will learn together. The theme for today is we are drawing from the great heritage of English National Ballet, and we are diving into one particular piece called Sphinx by Glenn Tetley. And what struck me with this piece, I've been looking at a lot of archive pictures, is the very architectural structure of the work, the kind of enjoyment of lines, of shapes, very geometric and quite beautiful. So we will be exploring this idea of geometry, this idea of constructing movement from point in space and body parts moving in volume and moving in the room around you. So I really hope you're gonna enjoy this moment together. And first thing we're gonna do is a little warm up. Okay guys, so before we dig deeper into our creative session, I wanna do a little bit of a warm up with you, getting you ready to move. So it's gonna be quite simple, you're gonna follow me. I will be talking you through the exercise, but do at the same time then you see me do it. So we're gonna start by just grounding ourselves a little bit in the floor, meaning that you're gonna find a nice parallel position and start to spread your toes out. Try to start to feel your spine growing, the top of the head is going to the ceiling. I'm gonna relax a little bit the hip joints, so bend your knees, allow your weight to drop down. We're thinking about opening our shoulders, kind of relaxing the front of the chest, making sure we are nice and relaxed and open for this session. So you can close your eyes for a second just to feel that position. Obviously you're going to have to open them again to see me do the rest, but for now just close your eyes, feel your toes into the floor, your heels into the floor, and focus a little bit on your breathing. Taking a few deep breaths, trying to relax the torso. Shift the weight slightly forward onto your toes. See where the edge of your balance is. And then you get yourself back to the center. We're going to do the same to the right. Kind of tilting, feeling where the edge is. back to the center. Same to the left. And then back to the center, and then same to the back. To shift the weight on the heels a little bit harder this time. Feeling how your stomach needs to engage, your legs are changing. And then at your own pace, we're gonna go slightly different directions, to the diagonals, to the front. Kind of really feeling your feet on the floor, nice and spread. Testing your balance. Imagining your center, so seeing how your spine, where your spine would be if you were standing still, and kind of moving the body around it. This motion a little bit smaller, even more to your center, kind of getting yourself back. And again, visualizing your spine, how your skull is just resting on top of it, and slowly coming to a still. Taking the plie, we're just going to bounce a little bit, sending that weight into the floor, bouncing down, 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 down. Really feeling the whole of your feet, the sole of your feet being kind of connected. Maybe a little bit faster, down, 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 relaxing the shoulders, relaxing the arms, and maybe evolving a little bit the shoulders, sending everything into the floor using the breath. Stretching out again, long necks, feeling the top of your head, and looking at how the flow of your blood has changed, how you feel your arms a little more alive. Good. So a little bit of something for the spine. I'm just gonna start rolling the head from the top down, not very far. Then you take a small plie and then you roll yourself back in. And then you stretch one more time down to the floor. And to the back. And stretch to the stand over here again. Down to the front. And feel to roll back. And push the heels further down. Down a little bit further. And still plie to come back. And then stretch the legs. Up again, down, to go down, and a plie, coming back, and push, to come up, all the way down now, all the way, and you stay down, now bend both legs, and then stretch both legs, one more time, bending both legs, and stretch both legs, one last time, bending both. And stretching both. Now you bend both legs down, you bring your right hand to the ceiling, doing a torsion, looking up and stretching. We're gonna stay there for a little bit, really trying to open the right shoulder up in the air. And then drop the arm, bend both legs, and again stretch both legs. Same on the other side, bending both legs. And then bringing your left arm up to the ceiling, stretching up, opening the shoulder. And when you're ready, bring everything down into a plie and a stretch. Now we plie all the way down, bending those knees, getting onto your heels, and then just trying to relax in your hips and in your knees. We are shifting the weight forward a little bit onto our hands, stretching the toes and back, and again forward, stretching the toes and back, and again forward, stretching the toes and back, and last one forward, stretching the toes and back. Now we're going to swing a little bit in the hips, so you're bringing both your knees to the right side, twisting the lower back, and then both to the left. And again, both to the right. And both to the left. Nice. And again, both to the right. We're trying to relax the muscles. We are making sure we are grounded and connected with the floor. From this position, I'm just going to go out into a plank. And bringing my torso down to the floor, breathing in, just stretching the stomach, and then breathing out, pushing myself back into a downward facing dog position, really spreading the toes into the floor, and maybe walking through your feet, and then walking forward to your hands. And stretching your legs, bending your legs, and then back up. Okay, good. So a little something just to kind of free, you know, the lower back and start to articulate that body. Now, second thing you're going to do today, arms up into the air, just trying to relax the shoulder, just feel again the length in your neck, and we're going to drop the right arm, and then catch it back. Same thing on the left, and then back up. And again, right, and back up, and then back. Great. Now we're going to swing forward, rotate the arms around, and then both arms. We start the same thing on the left side, and up. Then on the side, and up. Four times, side, and up, and side. And up forward, bounce, and stretch, and stretch. One more, two loops, and sides, and forward, and sides. And really reaching sideways, and forward, and back, and lift. And for the last one, left, and up, and right, and up again, left, and up, and right, right, and up forward. Bounce and back and lift and hold. All right, not bad, guys. I'm gonna take a few pauses just to open the hips again. So, big lunge, hop, and one leg behind you. Nice stretch, opening the shoulders, making sure you go quite deep in your left hip. And then take one nice stretch, coming with a twist. And then from there, bringing everything in, and a little stretch of your front leg, looking to the side. Great. Coming out of that, into down, facing up, stretching. And then walking forward. And rolling up. Same thing with the other leg, so left leg behind. Kind of nice rounded position, opening the shoulders, and then twisting to the side, looking to the ceiling, opening those shoulders again, dropping the pelvis, and then getting yourself into a little knot position, stretching the glute muscle of your right leg. Coming out of it, into a down facing dog, stretching forward, and then walking forward, and rolling up. Good. Few pliés. So, in parallel position, we start together with a demi plié and a stretch. Second one is a curve and a stretch. We repeat demi plié and a stretch and a relevé. Up and a down, one more, demi, and stretch, and a curve, and stretch, and demi, and stretch, and up, and down, one more, demi, and stretch, curve, and stretch, demi, and stretch, up, and down, last one, demi, and stretch, and curve, and stretch, and demi, and stretch, and and down in first, same thing, demi, and stretch, go stretch and demi, and stretch and leve up and down and demi, and stretch and go, and stretch and demi, and stretch and leve twice more and demi, and stretch and go, and stretch and demi, and stretch and leve and down and demi, and stretch with a curve down. And stretch and demi, and stretch really up and down. Same second, demi, and stretch, curve, and stretch, demi, and stretch, open the shoulders, and down, demi, and stretch, and a curve, and stretch, demi, and stretch, really, and down. All right, good. Okay, so now we're going to work together on a little improvisation task. Simple, but it's something that I want to focus on today. So it will help us when we start learning our sequence, but also when you start being creative a little bit later and create your own sequence. So today we're working with geometry. We are working with kind of angles and how we place our body in the space and how we create some kind of architecture with our body. So we're going to use this simple tool of imagining in front of us a big rectangle. So imagine a rectangle that is slightly taller than you, slightly wider than you, with two corners there. So straight line, two corners, and down to the floor with two corners. Now we're going to put numbers through this rectangle. So you have the first corner will be number one, middle of that edge will be number two, and then the second corner will be number three. Middle of this edge will be four, center of the rectangle will be five, and then the next middle of the edge will be six, and then on the floor, same thing, we have seven, eight in the center, nine in the corner. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay? Now, the improvisation is very simple. You're gonna go with different parts of your body and you're gonna direct those body parts towards a number. So if I decide to go 5, which is the center, with my hip, I will make a motion with my hip to the center. And then if I decide to move my knee to number six, number six goes, my knee goes to number six. So we are creating a sequence of movement, quite random, imagining this kind of grid. You don't have to know the exact number in your head, but you just need to know that there's 9 points in front of you and you want to move different body parts towards those different different points. Yeah, so quite simple. The first time we'll do it, I'm gonna play a little bit of music, and then we're gonna do it for about 2 minutes, just focusing on finding interesting body parts. So don't stay fixed with only doing it with your hands or with your feet, but think about the rest of the body, the core, the ribs, the ears, you know, the knee, the back of the knee. You have all these parts of the body that can be involved. So I'm just going to give you a bit of a demonstration. So we can go elbow, hand, head, buttocks, knee, chest, and so on. Really trying to get those in all directions. We're still using this as a warm-up as well. So really try to go quite deep into those motions. And also change levels, you know, things can happen on the floor as well as going a little bit higher up in the air. Okay, so I'm gonna give you 2 minutes. This is something you do on your own, but I'll be playing a little bit of music for you. Okay, go for it. Okay, great. I hope you enjoyed that. So now we're going to look at a similar task. We've been so just thinking about those body parts and those points. Now I'd like you to think about a couple of new elements. So first of all, how we create pathways between those different points. So if I'm here, a lot of the time we can just make direct motions, you know, meaning we go with the body straight to the point where we want to go, as simple as grabbing a handle or you know, drawing a line. Now we're trying to make this a little bit more three-dimensional. So instead of always thinking point, 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 I might start to think about pathways and also how I move in the space at the same time. So that makes me think things like this: point, move back, point, up, and then shift. Now a little bit of a melt, maybe placing my head in this corner, and then taking away, stomach to the center. So this is an example of how we can think about the pathway, meaning we are kind of coming in and out of that rectangle. So we're going to incorporate this. Now we're going to incorporate a second element to our little improv, is the idea of kind of different qualities, different intentions to the movement. So instead of just thinking straight to straight, I can also think, you know, slow motion, acceleration. I can think of something that has some kind of an awkward vibration into it, or I can also think about bounciness. So everything I do for a little bit is about bouncing. Yeah? So this is also very much up to you to come up with kind of interesting different type of motion. So again, I'm going to play some music. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to experiment, play with it. But this one, still go through your body, go through those different places you've discovered before, and now add how they interact with the space and with the music and also with the rhythm of your action. Okay, we'll see you in 2 minutes. Okay, welcome back. So the last part of our improvisation today will be how can we expand this grid that we created, which was very much in front of us, in a three dimension. So we're going to think that there is a grid of nine numbers in front of us, but we can shift it to the profile. So we can have the same grid here, and then we can shift it to the back. So we can have another one there, and then shift it to the other side here. Yeah? We can even imagine that there's one that is right where we stand, with two points here, one in front, one in the center, two to the side, and two to the bottom. So now I am surrounded by loads of points, those diagonals, the sides, the bottom, underneath me, behind. So all my action starts to be really connected in the space in general, and not just with one front. I can decide that I start here, hop, I do my little shift, but suddenly I want to be backwards, and then that changes where I want to be and change to the profile and hit to the back and so forth. So you really start to really open up the way you can move in that space. Yeah? So, quite simple, same thing. I'm gonna give you again a little bit of time with some music to explore this on your own. What I'd like you to do when you do this is really don't go too fast. Take this time. Think about what you're doing. I'm reaching a point, I wanna go to another point, I wanna melt down, I wanna come back up, jump. So all this, you need to visualize where in the space you're gonna go. And if you go too fast, it's just gonna be kind of random move coming around. So take the time, breathe in, listen to the music, and remember we are just trying to extend our physicality into the space and free our articulations, finding different kinds of texture in your bodies. Okay? I see you in a little bit. Okay, so we are now running a choreography sequence. So I'm gonna take you through all the steps, and I will be showing it to you facing the camera first. So at home, you will have to kind of do the right arm when I demonstrate the right arm, but I do recognize that it's not exactly that simple. So I will also demonstrate at some point the same thing facing the back, so you get a chance to see both angles, and I believe it'll be easier for you to follow. Okay, so let's start. This is a phrase that is very geometric. It's all about finding points and lines in space, and shaping the body almost like a piece of architecture. So we start in ballet position, standing kind of up straight, and then the next thing you're going to do is take a step with the left arm and shifting the right arm down into the diagonal. Yeah, so quite simple, left foot, right arm. I'm in a deep lunge, quite low, and from this position I bring my right elbow behind me, hitting a little point behind me, and my right arm, my left arm stretches to the side. Yeah? So we are here, step, diagonal, stretch. Almost like pulling a bow here, except you have your hand flat. One more time. One, two, and three. Good. Now from this position, we're gonna try to bring everything into a turnout position, so heel to heel, elbows to elbows. There, there, and then we go into a turning position. Okay, one more time. Step, deep, flat, turn out, turn in. Okay? So really thinking about the weight of your body into the floor, trying to be low, having those legs, straight line, really geometric. Then open the front, the chest, look to your left side. From there, bring yourself in, touching the elbows. We're in first position, and then bring everything. Okay, so then, right arm, left arm, you can follow with the gaze. One, two, shift up to the ceiling, and then bring everything down. I'm taking a small dummy point on my right foot. So, I right here, bend there, bend there, there, right, left, up, down. Now it's almost like you want to squeeze something between your arms. So really big squeeze, and then breathing out small curves in the torso, closing, okay? Let's try to look at that facing the other direction, which might be a little bit easier for you to follow. Step down into this diagonal. Open, stretch out. Now, turn out, turn in. Right arm, left arm, up, and then bring everything in. One more time. We go. Step down. Open, in, sorry, out, in, right, left, up, down. Okay, great. Shall we do a little bit more? We are in this curved position, heel of the floor with your right foot, and then out of this one, you want to bring yourself up, turn that leg out, and just to develop this side. Fall on the leg. Yeah? So, down, turn, develop it, down. Okay? Now from this one, we bring the left leg around into passive, hop, and fourth position forward, bringing your arms in first in front of you. So, we've arrived here, we have coupé, develop it, down, roll the jump down, arms in first. Okay, Now from this, you're quite grounded. You want to be quite low in the pelvis. Relax the center, also relax your tail. So the tail is just dropping down. Arms in front of you, and they're gonna shoot behind you, one, two. It's almost like going from a circle into a V shape, like a reversed V, behind yourself, yeah? So one more time, from low, we go. Développé, step, rond de jambe, down, arms, one, two. Okay, let's see that facing the back. So we are down here, and we are going Développé, side, step, rond de jambe, arm, right, left. One more time. All the way down, and Développé, side, rond de jambe, force, arms, one, two. Good. Let's try to put all this together and see how that works. So from the top, we have left foot, right hand, open, in, out, sorry, out, in, open, open, up, down, Développé, step out, plié, arms, right, left. Okay, one more time facing this, and then we'll do it facing the other side. So, one, two, here. And then arm, arm, up, down. Develop, rond de jambe, down, arms, one, two. Okay, let's try facing the back of the room. Same thing, we start, leg, arm, open. And one, two, up, and down, change. Rond de jambe, arms, one, two. Okay, last time for you guys. We go, step, down, flat. Turn out, turning, open, open, up, down, leg, change. Plie, arms, right, left. All right, now I'm gonna give you a little bit of time to think this phrase through on your own, and then we'll get back and we'll go a little bit faster. Okay, and we're back together. So I hope that was okay for you to be on your own. Just to recap this phrase. So let's have a look at it together one more time, and then we will be adding a bit of material to it. So we had step, arm, open, turn out, turn in, right, left, up, down, in the leg, with the rond de jambe, with the arms, right, left. Okay, facing the back. Step, deep lunge, open up, turn out, turning, right, left, up, down, in the leg, rond de jambe, down, arms, right, left. Okay, good. So let's look at the next few bits. You are here, you're in deep lunge, you have your arms behind you. Now it will all start in your left leg. So there's going to be a rotation, hop, to turn in, and then a curve in the stomach. and in your arms. So, from turn out, turning, bringing both arms in. Now we're going to stretch the right and the left, and curve again, and again the right and the left. Yeah? So, we have here, turning in, curve, right, left, curve, right, left. Okay, from this one, your right arm goes to your shoulder, your left side closes in, first position. Yeah, so stretch in the diagonal, up. Then we have an exchange, right arm goes down, left knee goes up, boom. Okay, so looking at that one more time. We are here, curving in, right, left, curving in, right, left, together, up. Okay, quite simple. Let me show you from the other side. We are here, we are going, turning, up, up, close, and up. All right. So, now imagine you are here, you've just dropped this, we're going to take a big back to that first position. So here, there's a sense that you're falling off, falling over, and fall. Flat to this one, but then there's a little change here. So you're going with your right arm around and placing your right elbow in your left hand. Oh! Okay, so let's look at that again. Finish here, curving in, right, left, right, left, in, change, forward, hop, stretch, and then hit the elbow. Let's do that together, facing the back. And left foot, up. Second time, first, lift, down, out, and in. Just a reminder, when I say facing the back, I am facing the back. You stay in the same position, but it's just probably easier for you to see me from the back, so you can directly copy my directions and you don't have to translate right to left and all of that. Okay, so let's try to recap everything from the start before we add a little bit more to this sequence. We have first move, second move, then we go turn out, turn in, right side, left side, up and down. Then we have the leg, rond de jambe, the arms, and then we go one, two. Now we can turn in, curve, right, left, curve, right, left, first up, repeat of the beginning two moves, and then going boom into our elbow. Facing the back, one more time, doing the same thing. So we are going down with the arm, opening up, turning up, turning in, open, open, up, down, in the leg, out, roll the jump. Deep. Then you have one, two, curly. Again, one, two, curly. One, one, two. Going first, knee, drop down, open into the elbow. I'm going to keep going a little bit from here. So you have your right elbow in your left hand. What we are doing here is throwing the right arm all the way around to the ceiling, placing your left arm on the floor. So, a bit of like a windmill motion. You're going through and across, yeah? And then I'm bringing this right arm over my neck, left arm over my neck, and both hands on the floor. One more time this. So, we are with the elbow, we're going windmill motion, up, bring the hand, cross your a right leg on top of your left, left arm, and then both to the floor. Yeah, so if I show you the other way around, so I can actually see you, well, not see you, but you can see me and what's happening in front of me when we are doing this. So you remember we were elbow in hand, windmill, change, cross. From this one, bring right hand over, left over, pose down. Yeah? One more time. Here, going down, step down, right arm, left arm, both. Now the next move is initiated by your right foot. So you send the right foot out, at the same time you send the right hand over, and then you just change to being this kind of little planky thing. Bent legs, bent arms. So I am here, I am sending arm and foot and change. A little hop and get yourself up. Yeah? So we just arrive to the floor, hop, open. You go, change tight, hop, come back. Yeah, for clarity, facing the other side. From the moment we have the elbow, we are going down and around, cross over, one, sorry, both together, down. Then you go, foot and hands, push, come back up. Yeah? So if you are in the same direction as me, facing the back, we're here, we're going arm around, hop, grab the neck, the other one, out, step, change, push, come. So, shall we recap this whole thing from this middle of the sequence, just been arriving before. Here with the arms, there, turning in, pressing down, right, left, pressing down, right, left, up, change, down, up, elbow, windmill, right arm, left arm together, changing, hop, and coming back up. Okay, I will give you a little bit of time in a few minutes to sing this through. But before, let's kind of catch the last few moves of this sequence. So you've got yourself up, you are here. What we're gonna do now is turning the left foot out, you bring your right foot in into a fifth position. Then we're gonna tilt to the side, so you've just arrived. Tilt, bending both legs, curve forward and come back to first, and this is it. So from the moment you bring yourself back up, turn out, fifth position, out, plie, get yourself in, and then back up. And we finish very simple, open in a first. So if you look at it from the back, just coming up, turn the left, back in, sideways, plie, arms down, up, and we finish. So, let's recap all those sections. I'm gonna give you each section with a really little pause in between, so you figure out what they are. And then what I'll do is I will give you a few minutes to kind of go back, think things through before we start looking at counts and how they work. Let's do it with me facing the back so you have a right angle for this. So first little section, step down, open to the side. Then we have turn out, turning, right, left, up, down. Leg goes out, roll the jambe, big round in the arms. Right, left, foot and then curving in, up, Maybe one arm at a time, up, and then first position, up. Falling down, open again, elbow, with to the floor, then neck, neck, open, change. Push forward, turn out, feet, sideways, lift up, and it is quite a long phrase, so I'm going to do it with you one more time. And then once we've done this, you'll have a few minutes for yourselves. One more time. And down. Open. And out, in, right, left, up, down. Change. Change. Curve. One, two, bounce. Then we go up, up, down. Up, up, first. Lift, forward. Up, elbow. Change. Up, in the neck, open out. Change, out, up. Running up to go, change, feet. Sideways, plie, and bounce. And okay, now have a think and then I'll catch up with you in a couple of minutes. Okay, and you are back. So we're gonna now put all this on counts. So it's a little bit more structured, a little bit easier for you to know the length of each movement before we add all of that onto the music. So, starting parallel, first count. It's very square in the beginning. We're going one, two, then we have an acceleration. We go three and four, five, six, down, seven, eight. Okay? So that is one, two, three, and four, five, six, down, seven, eight. Missing the other side. Go one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight. Now you want to start on an end. And one, two, three, four. So you've just finished, you're down here. You want to go and one, two, three, four, four with the arm. Five and six, seven, eight. Okay? So that is, where am I? All the way down here. You go, and one, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight. Now, from this, it's the same kind of rhythm twice. We go, and one, two, three, four, and five. Now you go, six, seven, eight. Looking at that one more time. So we finish seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight. Okay, putting everything from the top with counts together. And one, two, three, and four, five, six, down, seven, eight, and one, two, three, arms, four, five, and six, down, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, hold, six, seven, and eight. Good. Okay, I keep going. Once again, I will give you a little bit of time later on to think this through. So, finishing here on an eight. We start again. One, two. This time, three, hold, four. We're gonna have a little pause here. We're gonna go one, two, three, hold, four, to go five, six, seven, and eight. Okay, so we finish with both hands up on eight. That is one, two, three, hold, four, to go five, six, seven, eight. To go one, two, three, up, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, to finish, just to breathe, to know where you are. Okay, so, up here on an eight, going one, two, three, hold, four, going five, six, seven, eight, to go one, two, three, four, to go five, six, seven, eight, to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and so on. Okay, what I suggest now, we go once again quite slowly through the counts. I'm gonna do it once facing you, once facing away, and then I will give you again a little bit of time to just think those through for yourself before we try to put all of this on music, okay? So, first one. One, two, three, and four, five, six, down, seven, eight, and one, two, whoops, three, arms, four, five, and six, seven, eight, arms, one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, to go one. Two and three, hold, four, two, four, five, six, seven, left, eight, to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, to go one, two. Okay, one more time facing the back. We have one, two, three, and four, five, six, down, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, down, five, six, seven, eight, to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, once again, have a little bit of time on your own to practice this. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so now is the time to put it on music and to do that with counts and music. So I will probably be counting first on top of the music so you get a sense of the rhythm. And we'll do like we did before, I'll be facing you first and then I'll be facing the back. Okay, let me bring up my computer so that we can have a bit of sound. I will count 8 in and then we'll do it the first time. Okay, and we're back. So now we're gonna try to do this whole sequence with music. I think we're gonna do it with me counting on top of the music as well first. So it's not so jarring or difficult first. And like before, I'll do it with you facing, you know, the front and then facing the back. So you get a chance to see it from both perspectives. And hopefully that'll be helpful. So shall we have a listen? So we're gonna do this section once. I'll count probably 1/8 in before we start moving. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2. Okay, I'm sure it was great. Let's have a quick pause. So there's a lot to think about in this sequence. Obviously there's a rhythm, but I think what is important is the sharpness of the positions. You know, we're working with something very geometric, very clean, very direct. So we're trying to find this, and then within this kind of geometry, we're trying to find the breathing and the movement to go from one place to the other. So just to describe that a little bit more, this is like cutting, like going straight down. Hop, same thing here, straight, kind of established in your legs. Then quick, 1, 2, and then open, open. All of that, you know, big motions, and then sharp little attack, grounding yourself again. Yeah? So all those are kind of qualities, weight, sharpness, direction, that I'd like you to think about when you are now working on this phrase with music. So let's do it one more time, facing the back of the room. Or just one more second. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. Good. Shall we do that one more time facing the back? And then we'll try one more time without me counting. So twice more for today. Okay, be ready. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and four, five, six, down, seven, eight, and two, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, hold four, one, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two. Okay, excellent. We're gonna do one last time without me counting together. Great. All right. So I think that's it for this phrase for now. Have a little breather, drink a little something, and we'll get to the next part of this session. Okay, guys, we are arriving to the last part of today's session. So, you know, we've warmed up with improved together, we've learned a sequence, and now it's a bit of time for you to take all this on board and create your own choreography with a few prompts that I will be giving you now. So we've been looking at this very particular type of movement, very geometric, thinking about points in space and how to link those points together, moving the body in two different places of the room. This has been inspired by kind of pictures of a piece called Sphinx by Glenn Tetley. And this piece is very geometric, architectural lines in the way it's constructed. So I thought it would be interesting for you to explore this through the phrase that we've done, but also through what you're going to be creating yourself now. So you're going to follow two simple prompts. You're going to go back to what we've been doing during the improvisation, the idea of our grids. So those nine points in front of you and the fact that you can change them around and place them all around your body, so you have really three-dimensional movements. But the way you're going to construct your phrase is you're going to randomly list body parts. So I'm going to, if I was to do it myself, I would go, okay, heel, forehead, hip, ribcage, right ear, and so on. Thinking of maybe to start with doing eight of those, so that gives you potentially eight movements. And then equally randomly, I'm going to think about directions. So I could think about, you know, right in front of me, and then diagonal back, and then diagonal down next to me. Those would be my first 3 points. And then I would match the kind of body parts that I picked on my list to those directions. So I said heel, then I said forehead, and then I can't remember what I said afterwards, but let's say elbow. And then I had three movements. One, two, three. And like that, I can construct a sequence that will be quite geometrical. So really thinking about clear body parts, potentially seeing body parts that are spread across the body, so it gives you quite a lot more range for your movement. And similarly, also picking points that have contrast. I mean, it might be interesting to do things that suddenly are close together and then expand and shift, but this will be very much up to you. So this is your main task, and then to add to this task, I will ask you also to maybe reference a few of the movements that we had in the original phrase that we learned together. This is to kind of give a bit of coherence to the whole sequence you're gonna make. And if you want, then play the music and perform the sequence we learned together plus your own sequence on the back of that. I think it would be nice if you can create a sequence that is roughly the same length than what we've learned earlier today. Okay, great. So you're gonna have those instructions coming up on the screen very soon. And I hope you will enjoy that little creative task. You can always pause them if you want to take more time. I'll come back to it on another day. Good, well, it's been fun doing this with you. Thank you very much for watching at home and for participating. And I hope to see you at some point in a studio somewhere soon. Take care.
Thank you, Renaud, for sharing your wonderful knowledge. I hope you all enjoyed that at home. Don't forget, we're back tomorrow morning for day 5 of the English National Ballet Youth Dance Summer Intensive, where we'll be joined once again by the wonderful Crystal Costa for a very special yoga class. We will see you then.